granted, it's enough to make a man cry, which is what Steve Lavin, the Bruins coach, did after the game.
And it's great to win a national championship, but you just want your team that's been through so much adversity, you know, with the loss of their head coach, just to share that and experience that. And I knew they weren't going to get that opportunity. So it just made it tough because we've been through so much together.
My God.
Thank you. Minnesota 1997 NCAA Final Four. We're going to print one that says the NCAA champions pretty soon. Those things will be a hot item. I'll wear this one proudly. Thank you very much, Garvin. We're going to have much more coverage down here as the plane is on its way, winging its way back here to land down at the international airport. The fans are going crazy here. They're going to stay crazy for another hour, hour and 15 minutes as we continue our coverage. We may break away for a period of time to go to WCCO Television News, but in the meantime, we'll keep you posted on everything that's going on in this fabulous Golden Memory celebration of the 1997 season of this Final Four championship Golden Gopher basketball team. Channel 4 continues.
And for the first time in 15 years, the Big Ten Basketball Championship will come to Minnesota.
In the euphoria that followed, the Gophers received commemorative hats and t-shirts, and finally, a website on the basketball internet. Call it www.BigTenChampionship.com.
Jacobson comes up with it. Jacobson. The Golden Gophers to the Final Four in Indianapolis.
You want to dance? You want to dance? Okay. You want to dance with you? You want to dance? You want to dance? I want. Hey.
That's a picture that is worth a thousand words. I'll not say anything about it except to say that Al McGuire is a good sport, and I want to see the videotape that Miles Tarver has been shooting all this time. If you were watching the game, one of the things they said was, what did Miles Tarver really want to do? He said he came over to the bench and said, I want a piece of Al McGuire. And they started dancing together, got down, and it was a very nice scene. We want to give you some of the great moments of tonight's game. You saw that in music. I want to tell you some of the shots that were taken.
Golden Gophers who are going to the Final Four. And they're just taxiing over right now. Lucky Mark Rosen is on that plane, and I'm sure that plane ride back, he'll tell us all about it once he gets here. We're at Signature Charter right now, where the Gophers have been coming and going all through their road to the Final Four, to Kansas City, to San Antonio, and they'll probably leave out of here also to head to Indianapolis next weekend. There.
Stay with us because we're going to stay on this picture as we watch this team come in. And we're going to try to intercut in between this shot here and the crowd here at the university and pick up some of their sound, Darcy, because the crowd is seeing the same picture that you are seeing. And we're going to try to get a shot because you're sitting right at the point where they're going to be unloading. You can see the big screen television here. You can see our shot from the live eye in the sky helicopter of the plane that has landed there at the Hubert H. Humphrey Metro Terminal. Here's the team. They're starting to go with Let's Go Gophers. And now we'll wait for the cabin doors to open. And we've got Dale up above. Dale, does it seem to be many people there waiting to bring the Gophers home? Dale, can you hear me?
Yes, I can, Don. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I got you.
Okay. There is quite a crowd of people. The buses are just pulling up to the plane. You can see the door just came out. They're parked here at Signature Aviation, just on the south side of the International Airport. And a big crowd, and hopefully they'll get moving here quite soon, Don. And we'll follow them on down towards you, and we'll give you a play-by-play as the motorcade heads towards the Williams Arena.
Like the ramp has just come down from the plane. We'll go down to maybe our floor camera, the ground level camera, to see the people as they come off. You know they're going to have to unload all of the equipment, but they've scooted the ramp up there to that big champion jet, which is the charter jet that took them down and back to San Antonio. When that plane took off from San Antonio, it was a little bit of a delay because there were so many people on board, they had to start asking some people to leave. We pulled a string or two and made sure that one of the people they did not ask to leave was our Mark Rosen. And we can't wait to see when this cabin door opens as these people come out, just exactly whose face starts to show. We'll try to give you a play-by-play as the individuals make their way off of the aircraft and also let you know what kind of crowd reaction you're going to hear from the people here who've all set up. They are really, really anticipating this. Here's those big CBS signs we've been seeing. Clem's big season, and now they're going to open up the door. Darcy, come on in. Tell us what you see there.
Yep, they're just opening up the door right now, Don, and they should be getting off in just a few minutes. Oh, here's Mike Max and Mark Rosen.
Mark Rosen, the first guy off. Okay, thank you. There's Hosea. Here comes Courtney James.
We are live with John Thomas. And John, how good does it feel to be back home knowing you still got some work to do, huh?
It's cold, first of all. I mean, it was nice and warm in San Antonio, but we're glad to be back. And we know we have a lot of work to do. If I'm correct, I think Kentucky won the game.
Right.
And we have a great challenge ahead of us. And hopefully we can overcome that challenge.
You got a lot of fans waiting for you at Williams Arena. What incredible support throughout this tournament. Minnesota just took over San Antonio as they did in Kansas City.
Definitely. I mean, the show up was just incredible. There were so many fans there. We had a whole section basically of the arena to dedicate to Minnesota fans. And we just want to thank everybody for coming out. We really do appreciate it. And follow us all the way down to Indianapolis and root us on to the whole championship.
All right, JT, thanks much. And what a fabulous second half comeback by the Gophers today.
Thank you. Thank you, Mark.
All right, John Thomas, co-captain of the Minnesota Gophers. I think Mike Max is over with some other guests as well. Max, we'll switch over to you.
We're getting cold over here, Mark, but it's going to be warm at Williams Arena. Quincy Lewis played a big role today. So did Courtney James. How's it feel to be back home?
Hey, it's a great feeling. You know, we love the cold. We miss it. You know, we just can't wait to get back to Williams Arena.
What was the key today, Courtney?
I don't know. Just getting everybody into the game. I mean, Sam and Bobby had a big game last game, but we tried to get everybody involved this game. They helped us.
A lot of people waiting for you at Williams Arena watching this on a big screen TV. Quincy, give him a message.
Here we come, baby. Final four on the road. We want to see y'all, all y'all, in Indiana, baby.
Back home for you, Courtney.
Back home. I've been waiting for a long time. I can't wait.
Hey, we gotta get these guys to the arena. So hold tight there. They'll be with you shortly. Send it back to the studio.
All right. Thank you very much. That's Mike Max from the Midwest Sports Channel. And we've got a big crowd waiting here in anticipation. It's going to take about 30 minutes for everybody to get clear. There is a huge crowd here waiting and just in anticipation of this. Let me show you what it says here. This is the new cover of the St. Paul Pioneer Press, and listen to this crowd. This is the Sunday edition, ladies and gentlemen, for sure. And take a look who's on the front cover. Clem Haskins waving that net around his head saying, we're going to Indianapolis. And that's what all those guys down there are saying as they load up. We're going to be here for now. We want to go to Dale Dobish, who's up in the live eye in the sky helicopter, and he's got a bird's eye view of what's going on down below him at the Hubert Humphrey Terminal, where the Gophers are getting ready to load up and get in the buses and head down here under an escort by the State Highway Patrol. Dale, what kind of route are they going to take, do you know?
Don, right now they're still unloading off the airplane. You can see the bus park right at the back of the airplane there, and they're coming down the gangway and going under the wing, climbing onto the bus. So hopefully things will get going here just momentarily. And as we said before, we're going to follow the motorcade down all the way to Williams Arena, right down to the barn. And we'll get back to you then. And as soon as this thing gets moving, we'll get back to you and let you know things are coming and give you pretty much an ETA when they get down to the barn.
Captain, what is the air temperature up there?
It's about 25 degrees up here, down at 2,000 feet.
Okay, in other words, it's about 60 degrees colder here than it was when the team left San Antonio. No wonder they were a little shocked when they stepped off that plane.
You know what? I hate to say it, but it serves them right.
You're exactly right. They've had a good enough time. Now it's back to hard work. Thank you very much. Dale Dobish in the live on the sky helicopter, and we're going to be using him quite a bit as we follow the team heading back here to Williams Arena, where a crowd is anticipating the arrival of the Final Four Gopher basketball team coming up here in just a few minutes. You're going to hear Dick Jonkowski's voice in the background as the crowd goes into its cheer. We're going to say, we'll be back in just a minute. Bobby Jackson. Well, you can watch a lot of basketball for an awfully long time, and you will probably never find a better performance over a series of games as you've seen Bobby Jackson perform. We've got a great crowd here at the Williams Arena as we anticipate the arrival of the Golden Gopher basketball team coming in here. Lots of fans in their maroon and gold. But you know what? Down in San Antonio, we impressed a lot of people with the fabulous support we had down there. In just a moment, we're going to tell you about all of that. But first of all, we want to go to Dale Dobish, who's in the Live Eye in the Sky helicopter, poised over the Champion Air Charter. Dale?
Don, the bus is leaving the airport, so the team is on its way. You can see the bus there, and right in front of the bus, of course, a police escort. And they just turned on Post Road here. They're heading out. They should be, well, they'd be on their way, so we're guessing, what, about 15 minutes, and they should be pulling into Williams Arena for you.
Now, how far do they have to go? What is the drive time like down there, Dan?
I'm guessing down about, oh, probably 12 to 15 minutes. If we could fly them over there, we could get them there in about 2 minutes, but I'm guessing they'll probably make it probably in under 15 minutes. So about 12 to 15 minutes from right now, they should be pulling up at Williams Arena. But we'll stay right over the motorcade, and we'll keep you appraised down of just how close they're getting and try to get you a pretty accurate time.
Dale, I know that you're operating the helicopter and trying to stay afloat at the same time trying to operate the camera. But let me ask you, do they have a number of police vehicles in front? We can't see from our vantage point.
We can see one police car in the front of the motorcade down, and see one car behind that, the bus, and two other cars. Well, there's a bunch of other cars behind us. Probably 15 cars behind the bus, one car in front of it, and the police car. So pretty good-sized motorcade, and they're, as we said, they're on Post Road now, just about getting ready to turn on 494 and head your way.
Yeah, I'm guessing about 15 minutes, Dale, so we'll be back in touch with you to get progress reports as that motorcade makes its way down here to Williams Arena. The traffic jam has subsided because everybody is inside this building. 15,000 strong inside here at the barn. That's a capacity crowd for this place, and they're just as loud as if they were playing for a championship game right here. They've had this sustained energy in here with a decibel level of about 9,000 from the very beginning, from the moment they set in here with only a few laws from time to time. They have come in here with some wonderful, wonderful enthusiasm, and they haven't let up. I can't even imagine what it's going to sound like when these people come in here. Now, just a moment ago, I want to go to Mark first, and let me ask you this question. You watch these guys play, not only for the couple or 3 years they've been playing together here, but what's it feel like to you as a hometown kid watching these fabulous ball players? We got, you know, we can talk about the guys who've come in from out of state, but, I mean, there's really something special about having a Sam Jacobson and a Russ Archambault and having a John Thomas, these guys who have played
for when, in high school when we
well,
were
that,
watching
that's
them.
What makes it so special, because Clem Haskins has developed a real program here. This is not about developing guys who might be here for a year or two. They know they have to pay their dues. They know they have to sit on the bench. They know they're going to go through rough times. Look what Trevor Winter went through.
Yeah.
Look what John Thomas went through. Look what Sam Jacobson's gone through. All of them. It's not easy being here. Everyone, the expectations of the fans are always higher. But the fact they stuck it out and are enjoying this moment. If you look on the court today and see John Thomas, Sam Jacobson, Trevor Winter, Russ even got in the game, Minnesota flavor, you can't help but feel good about it.
And the wonderful thing that Lewis said in the interview in the post game, they caught him right on the floor, so it was nothing that seemed to be fabricated by at a news conference later. Al McGuire asked about his role, the kind of sacrifice he'd have to make coming out as a Mr. Basketball in Arkansas, being a huge star, but coming off the bench. Quincy said, I had to sacrifice a little bit, but I do it for Clem Haskins because I came here to play for this man.
Don, they're just slowing down to make the turn into the lot.
Here they come.
You can see the corner of the building right there.
So, they're turning in.
The Gophers have arrived.
Okay.
You want to see some smiling faces? Well, it'll be another 30 seconds.
You remember the faces of Gary Gaetti and Herbig? Do you remember those faces?
These guys
we're going to see the same thing here, aren't we?
Like I said, even on the airplane, they had no idea they were going to be welcomed like this. They were talking about a nice reception at Williams Arena. A couple of them said, you know, we're supposed to have finals this week. May have to postpone those a couple of days. They're going to be going down to Indianapolis on Tuesday, by the way it sounds right now. Eric Nelson's outside. Eric, go ahead.
Okay, Mark, thank you. The bus full of champions is pulling into the Williams Arena parking lot now, and you can see the fans behind the barricade, the fans who did not get into the barn, so maybe it's fitting they'll get the first glimpse of their Final Four heroes. Here come the University of Minnesota Golden Gophers. There's Yvette Haskins. Here comes Courtney James. Courtney, how do you feel about going back home? It's an unbelievable scene. The Gopher players will now be entering the barn, and Don, you and Mark and the thousands in there will see them, and I would imagine the cheers in there will be deafening.
I think the roof's coming off this place, as a matter of fact. If you don't love what's going on here, you don't have a pulse right now.
That's exactly right. And it looked like maybe the coach had insisted that the players not talk, try to keep it to themselves, make their way into the building as quietly as they can. They may even spend a little time downstairs regrouping before they come up here. We don't know where they're going to enter from, but it usually will be from the standard position they always come up from whenever they take the floor here at Williams Arena, just off this raised floor. You listen to this crowd. Let's take a listen to what this crowd's doing. Boys and girls in the 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th grade, and see how many people are wearing their socks up around their knees. How many you'll find doing that, huh? Take a look at that. That is the Sunday edition of the St. Paul Pioneer Press front page for sure. Here come the Golden Gophers. Thank you.
Reaction. Did you have any idea when you stepped off the plane and into this building would be like this?
I mean, we heard it was like a couple hundred people here. We didn't know all 15,000 people was going to be here, so it's great. I mean, we got the best fans of college basketball.
You came from New York to Minneapolis. It didn't start out in a positive way, but this year has been so tremendous. What do you have to say about Minnesota?
Oh, Minnesota's a great place. A lot of people doubted my decision to come here, but I'm glad I came. I stuck it out for 3 years, and we're going to the Final Four.
I don't remember the final score. I do remember we won, and I remember saying at the end, the road to Indianapolis is now paved with gold.
Thank you. Let me just say a few words, let you know how much I appreciate this kind of support, and let you know that you're the reason that we're going to the Final Four. We set a lot of records this year, a lot of records for the future teams of Minnesota. We've had to accomplish a whole lot to beat these records. We're 15-0 at home because you would not let us lose at Williams Arena. Thank you for that. We go to Kansas City, we play two ball games. We won because you were there supporting us again. We go to San Antonio, Texas. We win two more basketball games because you're there again, support us again. And our next stop is Indiana. That's the Final Four. And Courtney James, no, we call it Naptown. But we're going to Indianapolis, Indiana for one reason, to play two basketball games and win a national championship. Thomas and Trevor, my co-captains, come say a few words. But let me say this.
As long as we have this kind of support at Minnesota, you can accomplish great things. And I will close at this time with my co-captains, Trevor John Thomas and Trevor Winter. Come say a few words.
Wow!
Everyone here, you just don't understand sometimes how much you really mean to us. The great turnout is so, we can't even put into words. I can't stop smiling. We did the unbelievable. Just pushed hard, worked hard. Everyone pushed us, and thanks to everyone here, we're going to the Final Four. We're gonna work really, really hard and go ahead and beat the Wildcats, advance the championship, and bring the championship back to Minnesota, baby. And now, Trevor Winter, please give it up.
Thank you, John. The season's been a dream season for everybody. Everybody in the stands and everybody you see here on this court tonight. Thank you. We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. We want to thank those people that were down in San Antonio that won't be back till tomorrow. I know they're having a good time down there too. Thank you for coming tonight. This is unbelievable. You know, I just, like John said, you can't even put it into words. To look up there and see that banner, congratulations, Final Four, here we come. I don't know how many of you are going to be in Indianapolis, but we'll see you all when we come home with the title.
We're going to have Slammin' Sam say a few words. Sam Jacobson.
What's up? Yeah. I just want to say a few words. We would not be in this position today without all you great fans. And I just want to say that you're the greatest. And keep supporting us and following us through the Final Four.
Thanks, Sam. Bobby Jackson, Mr. BJ, MVP.
What a job we did this year. Thanks for y'all's support. We wouldn't be here without y'all. It's a great feeling. We worked really hard to get to the Final Four, and Coach Haxton knew he had faith in us from day one, and we just ready to play the Wildcats. We lost an important part of our team down there. He couldn't be able to play the whole game, and we're just wishing the best for him. We want him to be back as soon as possible. He kind of separated his shoulder, but he's a big part of our team. And without him, we wouldn't be in this situation. Eric Harris!
of you out there, if you ever play sports, if you ever got hurt, and you try to come back from injury in less than 48 hours and try to do what you can for your team. This young man displayed today what he's all about. This is Eric Harris, played with a lot of heart today.
I just want to say that we love y'all. We couldn't have never made it without y'all. Y'all, when everybody else doubted us, y'all was always there. And I mean, we know y'all gonna be there to support us in the Final Four. Once again, thanks again. We love y'all.
Okay, it's okay, it's okay.